Mr. President, I rise to pay tribute to my friend Saxby Chambliss. I will have to admit to you, this is a speech I never wanted to make. I never wanted to make it because we've had a wonderful relationship in this body for the last 10 years. We've done everything together. He's had my back, I've had his back. He's a great friend and I'll miss him. But I'm not a selfish guy. He married one of the finest women I've ever known, Julianne Chambliss, who's one of the best friends my wife has. And I know those he's leaving us, and I'll miss the crutch I've used for so long. Julianne's getting her Saxby back, and for Julianne and her family, and for those grandkids that he loves so much, that's exactly what Saxby wants to do. You know, George has had some great senators. Richard Russell, who was really the master of the Senate. It had Zell Miller, the former governor of Georgia, a great friend of mine and a great mentor to our state. And Sam Nunn, one of the finest in national defense and foreign policy our state ever offered. Saxby is going to be the fourth on the Mount Rushmore of Georgia senators who served in Georgia with distinction and with class. I want to tell Saxby this personally. For 10 years, we've done joint press conferences. We've messed up twice. When I messed up, he covered my back, and when he messed up, I covered his. In fact, in 2008, when he almost lost a race and got into a runoff in December in Georgia, I rode a bus for 21 straight days introducing him three times a day and eating barbecue every single day for dinner and for lunch. That's a price to pay that only friendship will bring out of anybody. But he's a dear friend, he's a trusted person, and I love him very much, and I love his family very much. And I could talk all day, but I did just wanted to open up and close by saying, Saxby, I love you. The state's going to love having you back. This country's going to miss you. But my grandchildren are safer. My state is better. And our relationship has never been stronger. May God bless you and your family and every endeavor you take. And may God bless the United States of America.